Dear connectees, honorable members, dear guests, party leaders, all of them, all of the proposed, I have the singular honor of being part of one of the most important gatherings of political parties in the history of the government. You will agree with me that local organization will only be effective, efficient, and viable if one has stakeholders with the political will to cooperate with the central purpose of delivering free, fair, and credible elections, which is our mantra. The most important stakeholders of the IEC in the political process are the political parties. How they conduct themselves on the ground will determine to a large extent the quality of the electorate we could deliver. Today, I'm happy to note that the MOU that has since been signed by all the nine political parties and the body committee is also at the process of being institutionalized. I want to give my attention for the quality of their partnership with the endeavor to deliver credible electoral outcome. A lot of water has gone under the bridge, but there is hope for better relations between the IEC and this party. I don't close my remarks without touching on the content of the MOU. You have agreed as the registered political parties of the Gambia that a peaceful and stable political environment underpinned by a transparent, plural, and democratic political engagement is vital for the government's portfolio political prosperity, happiness, and well-being of its people. We have also agreed to recognize the legitimacy of the government and its right to govern within the confines of the constitution and other laws of the land. On one hand, and the right to the political opposition to operate freely and fairly and hold government to account, on the other. We have also agreed to put the past behind you and, in the high interest of the government, work constructively towards national reconciliation and the constitution of democracy, good governance, due process, respect for fundamental rights, and the rule of law in the government. To achieve these goals, we have agreed to a code of conduct to adhere to the constitution and the electoral laws, respect for the rights of all parties to convene freely without fear, respect freedom of press, respect free assembly, peaceful demonstration as provided for by the constitution and the laws of the country. We have agreed to conduct your activities at all times in a manner that contributes to peaceful atmosphere, abolition in general for the global language, campaign against violence and union, and respect the separate powers, refrain from using the arms of government, civil servants, public funds, for political campaigns or work. Finally, you have agreed to form the Independent Committee to promote dialogue and cooperation and ensure adherence to the code you have established for yourselves. You have clearly mapped out arbitration procedures to handle grievances. You have indicated how the IPC and the IEC could cooperate to facilitate electoral reforms and enhance partnership in electoral administration. As far as the IEC is concerned, this memorandum contains all the elements that could nurture the requisite interparty relationship that could promote the role of free, fair, and giving elections in the government. This workshop on the constructive dialogue is timely, and IPC is about to embark on the result of the population on the community. I enjoin you to make good use of